I want to show our viewers exactly why osteoporosis causes bones to break. We have a 3D image, and I find this to be very fascinating. And like you said, doctor, it's very important that we get this diagnosis because it could be detrimental.
Absolutely.
What are we looking at here, Dr. Mena?
Here we're looking at the hip bone. So what we're looking is the cross section, or basically slicing the hip bone in two. So you're seeing the inner part of the bone. So what you're looking is that the bone is a little more brittle. So there are more porous areas, more open areas. So what that means is that the bone is not as strong as so that can become fragile and eventually can break off, and people can develop fractures.
All right. And when something like this occurs, it is really imperative, Dr. Pazionis, to target this and take care of it, right?
Absolutely. So there's two factors that can be at play here. So firstly, the acute compression fracture. So if it's something like a hip fracture, that's something that I would take care of operatively at the time of surgery. If it's something like a vertebral body compression fracture, there are a number of schools of thought, which we'll discuss within this program, on how to deal with those. Oftentimes, patients are braced initially, but the underlying cause must be treated. So looking at the medical management, whether or not the patient should be on specific bone strengthening medications, or if it's something that is related to a cancer or a trauma, that also should be addressed and investigated.
And Dr. Mena, going back to the 3D image, which I'd like to take again, on a scale of 1 to 10, for example, how bad is this one right here, if we can show our viewers one more time, please?
1 being nothing, 10 being the worst. I would say this is about an 8, more or less, give
and take. And again, not treating it, we're looking into possibly having a hip fracture.
A hip fracture, and that can be debilitating. People can, obviously, with a hip fracture, they can suffer with pain, and that can impact their mobility and certain activity of daily living. And some people can be more bedridden for regarding based on this. And what we're looking, if they become a little more bedridden, people can also develop some other comorbidities alongside with it. So that's why we want to make sure to jump in and treat this as quick as possible to avoid the consequences that this can happen over time.
And Absolutely. Go ahead, Dr.
Mena, I mean, there is also some evidence within the orthopedic literature that, for example, hip fractures not treated within 48 hours can be actually detrimental to patients. And the 5-year morbidity from having a hip fracture is comparable to that of a heart attack.